trusted name in news.
Tonight, another break with tradition of the White House. President Trump's eldest daughter, Ivanka, has long been known as one of her father's unofficial key advisors. Now the White House confirms that she is getting an office in the West Wing, a move that appears to signal her role in the White House is growing. Now, you might remember that on November 16th, following news reports that his transition team was looking into security clearances for his adult children, then candidate Trump tweeted, "I am not trying to get top-level security clearance for my children. This was a typically false news story." Well, that was November. Kate Bennett has the latest.
Even though she won't have a formal title in the White House, Ivanka Trump will have something far more powerful, top security clearance. It's a controversial move considering the oldest Trump daughter has no government, national security, or foreign policy experience.
Thank you all very much. I appreciate it.
Thank you.
But for those who know her and her father, it's not a surprise. The 35-year-old is a key cog in the White House inner circle. And she's been at his side in Washington since he assumed the presidency, conducting roundtable discussions on women's issues with heads of state, like Canada's Prime Minister Justin Trudeau.
Welcome, and I'm honored to be here. I'm really looking forward to hearing from each of you who serve as tremendous role models for me and so many other business leaders across both of our countries.
And German Chancellor Angela Merkel just this past Friday, where Ivanka was present for another meeting, this time on workforce issues.
I want to thank everybody in the room. I want to thank my daughter Ivanka, who's with us today.
Popping up regularly at Trump's appearances.
Ivanka is here right now. Hi, Ivanka. And it really is very, very special.
Even getting a presidential shout out at a February press conference.
Helping her and working her will be Ivanka, who is a fabulous person and a fabulous, fabulous woman. And they're not doing this for money. They're not doing this for pay. They're doing this because they feel it, both of them.
And like so much of the Trump presidency, the arrangement is unprecedented, raising questions about conflicts of interest and the nature of her role itself.
It is very important that Ivanka Trump observe all of the ethics rules that everyone else does in the White House, because she is an employee. She is subject to those rules just like everybody else, regardless of whether she's getting paid or not. That is irrelevant. And she has to follow the ethics rules, and I hope she does so.
Ivanka has yet to speak about her evolving role or what it could entail, opting instead to showcase day-to-day activities, either working with her kids or at the White House via social media. And this father-daughter, colleague-family member relationship is unprecedented. And Ivanka's exact position continues to drive speculation and more questions than answers. Kate Bennett, CNN, Washington.
Back with Ryan Lizza, David Gergen, and Gloria Borger. You know, one forgets how, I guess the word is unique, a situation this is. I mean, if Hillary Clinton was the president and Chelsea Clinton was attending meetings without a portfolio and getting a security clearance to the White House, would that have been considered normal?
No. No, but this isn't, you know, this isn't either. It's normal in terms of Donald Trump's world because he's always had Ivanka Trump by his side in business, and she's a business partner, as are his children, his adult children. And what's strange to me about this, though, is that she doesn't have a title. And everybody who knows the turf in the White House, you need a title. She doesn't have one because she can be everywhere. And if I were in the White House and you were talking about this during the break, that would make me pretty nervous.
You don't need a title when you're the president's
well,
daughter.
Well, that's it, but that's what made me nervous.
I'm just trying to imagine if I was working for a company and my boss's kids were there.
Right. Yeah.
And they could walk into the office anytime and say whatever they wanted to the boss. And then I just think it would be such a weird dynamic.
There was a parallel with the Clinton Foundation when Chelsea Clinton took a senior role in the Clinton Foundation, and it did cause some you know, palace intrigue. This is very unusual. We haven't experienced in American politics a family taking over the White House.
Right. I mean, this happens in other countries where, you know, you go to the presidential palace and you get into the inner sanctum, and it's like the president and their cousin sitting around watching a soccer game, but it's kind of strange to have it happen here.
We haven't
We've had presidential daughters who've been famous, not very often. Teddy Roosevelt had Alice, who was boisterous and, you know, wore these huge hats. And Teddy once told the press famously, said, listen, I can either be president or I can manage Alice, but I can't do both. Uh-huh. and when Franklin Roosevelt was there, because Eleanor was gone a lot, his daughter Anna was around a lot for this. We haven't seen this. This is more like how a private company is run. Right.
Well,
she's sitting next to Angela Merkel.
Right.
And I think I would give her a pass, generally speaking. I mean, I'd give him press. As long, whatever helped him be a better president, I think we had it before. But I do question the national security clearance. That's
totally
the one. It's a stickler.
Well, her husband has national security clearance. And so she now has national security clearance without any delineated responsibilities, aside from her interest in working women. But so she can be in on meetings that other people in the White House cannot be in on. And she's privy to conversations with her father that others cannot. If I were working in the White House, I'd be very wary of this and Ivanka's power.
Well, one of the things I've talked to a number of former chiefs of staff, all who say, to have these advisors without a real portfolio who are just kind of able to go into meetings and then leave and then get into the president's ear, and they're all competing in different ways. Dave, why is it the security clearance that for you raises a red flag?
Because the security clearance does come with a capacity to read any cable that comes in. If we have another 13 days, God forbid, she'd be at the table. I just think that there are... we ought to have more respect for what the security clearances represent, and that is access to the nation's highest secrets. And I think she's fine there to be as a general counselor and all the rest of it, but I don't know why she would be at the table with the head of the Joint Chiefs of Staff to determine whether you're sending soldiers into conflict.
And what about the ethics issues, which we haven't even touched here, which is about how divorced is she from her business?
Right.
And if she's got that kind of security clearance,
because Jared has already agreed to the full ethics regimen, and because obviously they're married, all of her financial interests should, through Jared, already.
Although the paperwork hasn't been filed on Jared Kushner, so we actually don't know.
That all should go through the Office of Government Ethics, like any other staffer. I think the other thing, this is what you were hinting at with the former chiefs of staff, usually argue for a strong chief of staff and not a super top-heavy White House. Oh. This White House is the most top-heavy White House probably since, like, Ford. You've got about seven advisors at the same level as the chief of staff.
We got a gun. Just ahead, Senator John McCain voicing his concerns about former Trump campaign chairman Paul Manafort. He's not alone. I'll also talk to Congressman Jim Himes about the new allegations Manafort is facing over his ties to the former pro-Russian president of Ukraine.